Hi, I'm Georgia, and I currently teach a combined fifth and sixth grade classroom. I've been teaching for 5 years. For a majority of those years, I taught a special education classroom, and this is my first year in a mainstream classroom. I believe that in elementary school, we're really teaching the kids learning skills. And I believe that it's important to deliver these skills by providing a rich program full of engaging, relevant information, and by providing lots of opportunity for inquiry, differentiation, and fun along the way. I think one of the most important parts of my program is cross-curricular learning. I think it's really great for students not to pick up a book and then put it down when it's time to learn math, and then put down the math tools and start to learn science. I think by delivering a cross-curricular program, you invite students to investigate deeply into issues, to find lots of different ways to look at a topic, and to see that all the subjects are relevant to each other. I don't want the students to skim the surface. I really want them to dive in. I think that my special education background has really informed my teaching. I believe that a lot of the strategies I learned in teaching special education students are relevant and best practices in any classroom. I think it taught me that all students learn in different ways. In my classroom, I find it important to always have visuals on the walls. Now, this might be essential for 10% of the classroom, but the other 90% of the class is absolutely going to benefit from it. Another example of this is my delivery of information. I have to make sure that I'm not just teaching by oral presentations, or not just teaching by having students read the information. I think it's important that students have access to information in a lot of different ways. So we have discussions, we do some reading, the students write, we watch videos, we listen to presentations. This way, I'm accessing all of the different learning styles. I try to infuse the program with lots of activity. My students are very energetic. Definitely some of them are kinesthetic learners and need to be up and out of their seat. I coordinate their classroom jobs with their learning style. If a student is really active, I make sure that student has opportunities to get up and out in the school, deliver messages to other teachers, clean the chalkboard, hand out paper to students. This way all students feel like they have a place in the classroom and that they're successful. I think it's important to always connect the curriculum to the student's real life as well. At this age level, I find the students start to question the learning. They ask why a lot. Why are we learning this? I think it's important to always make sure that they can see the real life application of their learning. When we're working on measurement, we use real life situations and we connect to the real world so that they can see how this is relevant. I try to infuse inquiry into a lot of the different content areas. So the students are investigating things that they're interested in and that they feel connected to. I find it important to choose themes that run throughout the school year. This year we were working on a global partners project. This started in September and went all the way through to June. This way I can connect the different content areas, science, social studies, math, literacy, to this one theme, and they can really develop large bodies of work. I believe that the students should feel empowered in the classroom. I believe in student voice. These students will be our leaders in the future. And I believe in creating positive and productive citizens. They're citizens of the classroom, they're citizens of the community, and they're citizens of the world. I think that I can do this by creating relevant jobs for them in the classroom, by allowing their voice to be heard, by ensuring that they co-construct the learning with me, that there's lots of opportunities for inquiry in the classroom, and that we have meaningful conferences. This means that I sit down with the students and I understand how they're doing and where they're coming from. This starts in September by getting to know each and every one of the students, by building a community in the classroom where people feel comfortable and safe and where everyone trusts one another. My classroom has a very diverse population. Students have moved to our country either recently or several years ago, and each of them brings their own unique story and background to this room. I think it's important that all of these backgrounds are highlighted and celebrated. Being a diverse classroom is what makes us inspiring. I believe in modeling all the behavior I expect from students. This can be as simple as having a clean and organized desk. If I expect them to have a clean and organized desk, I better have one as well. If I expect them to use a positive tone of voice with each other, I should use a positive tone of voice with them. I'm teaching them these skills, and if I'm not following through with it, they won't either. I think that assessment in the classroom has to be differentiated just like the instruction does. I think that students demonstrate their knowledge in a variety of ways. We highlight their strengths as learners, musical strengths, artistic strengths, oral communication, reading and writing, strong math learners. And I think that this has to be present in assessment. I do this in the form of choice boards, allowing students different ways to demonstrate what they've learned. One student may choose to do a monologue, and one student may choose to be a news reporter. The monologue may draw on the student's strength as a performer, while the newspaper writer may be interested in current events. I think that differentiation of instruction is something that has been present in classrooms for a while now, but I think that differentiated assessment is something that is still emerging, something that I'm still learning about. At the beginning of the school year, I make it very clear to the students that I set high expectations for them, and I make it clear that I'm not going to lower these expectations. And it is their job to meet them, and it is my job to help them get there. It's my job to give them the tools, to show them how, and it's their job to believe in themselves and to do the hard work of meeting those expectations. We talk about this through the year. I ask them, do you want me to lower my expectations? I don't want to, and neither do they. We talk about how it takes hard work sometimes to meet those expectations, but the feelings of pride and the encouragement that they find with one another is truly inspiring. I think it's important that the students know I believe in all of them. Literacy is a major part of my classroom. I really love to read, and I make this very obvious to the students. One of my favorite things is read alouds. I find at this grade level, at the fifth and sixth grade, the students get less and less read alouds. But the enjoyment they get from hearing someone read them a story and the level of engagement is so high. I use read alouds in all the different content areas. For example, in science, I read them a picture book called Stanley's Party, which was the platform for some of their technological designs. In language, I read them a novel called Freak the Mighty. And in math, we read poems about homelessness.